Welcome to this video about installing Oracle VM VirtualBox on an Oracle Linux Cloud instance and using it to create a new guest virtual machine. Oracle VM VirtualBox allows the simple and fast creation of virtual machines, also referred to simply as VMs, supporting a wide variety of operating systems. This video demonstrates installing VirtualBox and its extension pack on an Oracle Linux Cloud instance, as well as the supporting packages for VirtualBox. It shows creating a new virtual machine using VirtualBox installed on the instance and installing the guest additions to the new VM. You can read more detailed information about Oracle VM VirtualBox at this documentation link. There is also a free hands-on lab available where you can practice the steps shown in this video in a real live environment. You can access the lab at this link, and at the end of this video, there is a link where you can access many more free technical hands-on labs covering a wide range of Oracle Linux topics. Our Oracle Linux instance is installed as a server with GUI, and here we're looking at the desktop of this cloud instance. To support the installation of VirtualBox on Oracle Linux, we first need to install some supporting packages. If you're installing VirtualBox on a Microsoft Windows instance, you don't need to install these supporting packages. We will do this from the command line. So we click on the Activities menu, then select Terminal to open the Terminal window. The required packages are installed using the command sudo dnf install -y kernel-uek-devel-$ open brackets uname space -or close brackets, and then name the packages gcc, make, and perl. The option uname-or will ensure that the matching development packages for the currently active UEK kernel get installed. The package's installation takes a few minutes to complete. If we change the UEK kernel of the host system later on, we will need to rerun the VirtualBox setup to recompile the driver modules. To have them automatically recompiled without the need to rerun setup, a useful utility called Dynamic Kernel Module Support, or DKMS, is recommended. Installing the DKMS package ensures modules are automatically recompiled if the Linux kernel on the VirtualBox host system is upgraded. The DKMS utility is found in the OL8_developer_EPEL repository, which can be installed from yum.oracle.com. Our system has the repository configuration, but it's not enabled. We enable it with the command sudo dnf config-manager --set-enable OL8_developer_EPEL. The repository is verified installed with the command sudo dnf repo list. Here we can see the OL8_developer_EPEL repo listed. Now we install the DKMS package with the command sudo dnf install -y DKMS. If this EPL developer repository is not configured for the system, you can use the command sudo dnf install -y Oracle-EPEL-release-EL8. Now to install VirtualBox. We click on the Activities menu and open the browser. Oracle VM VirtualBox is available and can be downloaded from the virtualbox.org website. We click on the Downloads link on the left side menu. As our host system is an Oracle Linux system, in the main window under VirtualBox 7.0.x Platform Packages, we click Linux Distributions. As the instance we are using with the desktop GUI is running Oracle Linux 8 under VirtualBox 7.0.4 for Linux, we right-click on the link for Oracle Linux 8 and select Copy Link. Returning to our terminal, we use the command sudo dnf install -y and paste in the link copied to the VirtualBox package. From the Activities menu, clicking the Show Applications icon, Oracle VM VirtualBox is now listed. Now we can open the VirtualBox application. I can close the notifications window showing can't enumerate USB devices. It's not needed. Next, we install the VirtualBox extension pack. Extension packs provide extra functionality to the VirtualBox base package, such as extended USB device support and cloud integration features. We return to the browser showing the VirtualBox page and click again the Downloads link on the left side menu. We scroll down to the VirtualBox extension pack section and click the link All Supported Platforms to download the extension pack. Here the browser saves the file to the downloads directory. To install the extension pack, we return to the VirtualBox application. To get to extension settings, we click the three dots icon on the Tools menu and select Extensions. Click the Install button, and from the Open Downloads folder, we select the extension pack file and click Open. Then click Install in the confirmation dialog. In the license dialog, we must scroll the text to the bottom and then click I agree. As I'm logged into the system as my user, I need to have the elevated privileges to make the install. So in the authentication required dialog, I give my user password and click authenticate. We see the extension pack is now installed. With VirtualBox ready, we can now create a new Oracle Linux virtual machine. To get back to the VM creation menu, we click the Tools menu and select Welcome. Here, we click New to create a new VM. We can use a guided mode to create the VM, but for this video, we will create using Export mode, which gives us more initial options to configure in a single-page multi-section dialog for the VM. Under Name and Operating System, I will give the name 008-6-new-1. To choose the version of Oracle Linux to install, we click the ISO image dropdown and select Other. In this video, I am installing Oracle Linux 8, but you can download the ISO version of the Oracle Linux you want from yum.oracle.com or the Oracle Software Delivery Cloud, edelivery.oracle.com. We select the pre-downloaded ISO file and click the Open button to select it for use. I will tick the Skip Unattended Installation box to prevent VirtualBox from automating the full installation. Oracle Linux has certain memory and CPU requirements, so we expand the hardware section by clicking the arrow beside the title. We will set the base memory to 8GB using the slider, or we could also use the input field. We set processors to 2 with the slider. Expanding the hard disk section allows us to define the size of the hard drive to be used with the new VM, but we will leave the default of 20GB. If we wanted to select a different hard disk type to be created, for example, VMDK or QCOW type, we would use the dropdown in the hard disk file type and variant section. We click Finish to create the VM configuration and a return to the VM parameters screen. Before starting the VM, we need to enable nested virtualization for our new VM to allow the pass-through of hardware virtualization functions to the guest VM. In the VM parameters, click on System to open the system settings for the VM. We select the Processor tab and tick the box for Enabled Nested VT-X AMD-V and click the OK button. We can now launch the virtual machine and install the operating system. We click Start to launch the VM and start the operating system installation. At the Linux Launch menu, we press the up arrow to select Install Oracle Linux 8.6.0 and press the Return key to begin the installation. Soon, we are presented with the Oracle Linux Graphical Installation Utility and click the Delete Finished Notifications button to close the overlaid notifications slider window. We take the default language setting and select Continue. When we click into the new VM window for the first time, we are presented with a window informing us that the mouse will be captured. To stop getting this reminder each time we click into the window, I tick the box Do Not Show This Message Again and click Capture. To get mouse control back outside of the VM window, we press the right control button on the keyboard. I'll skip forward through the installation steps, but if you want to see the steps to install Oracle Linux, you can watch this video and see the manual installation steps. We can now click Begin Installation to install the operating system to the VM. The install will take a few minutes, so I'll fast forward through this. When the installation is complete, we click Reboot System to restart the VM and launch the new operating system. After the VM has rebooted, on the initial setup screen, we click License Information. We tick the box for I accept the license agreement and then click Done. We can now click Finish Configuration. After a short while, the operating system presents us with the desktop GUI and the welcome screen. We click Next on the welcome screen. We click the slider to turn off the location services and then Next. Then click Skip to continue without connecting online accounts. I input a name for a new user into the full name field and the same name is used in the username field and then click Next. We set a password for our user and click Next. And finally, we click Start using Oracle Linux Server to finish the initial setup. And we can close the Getting Started window. That's our new VM built and running. To support additional useful VirtualBox features, we can install the optional VirtualBox Guest Editions to the guest. To prepare the VM for Guest Editions, we must install supporting packages. These are the same packages as we used to prepare our host system before installing the VirtualBox application. As this is a new Oracle Linux install, it's always recommended to update the system to ensure you're using the latest software and packages. But we will go straight to installing the Guest Editions software. On our VM desktop, we click the Activities menu and open the terminal to our VM. we install the packages with the command sudo dnf install -y kernel-uek-devel-$ open brackets uname space -r close brackets and the packages gcc make and perl. And we give our user password to run the command at elevated privileges. When the software install completes, we can then install the recommended dynamic kernel module support or DKMS package. This is as we did for the install of the VirtualBox on our host system. As the new VM has only the default repositories installed, to support the install of the DKMS package, we need to install configuration for the OL8-developer-epel repo. We use the command sudo dnf install -y oracle-epel-release-el8. We can verify the repositories installed and enabled with the command sudo dnf repo list all. Here we see the two repos for EPL enabled. Now we install the DKMS package with the command sudo dnf install -y DKMS. This will take a few minutes to complete. With the support packages installed, we can install the VirtualBox guest additions to our VM. To access the VirtualBox menus for the guest window, we press right control on our keyboard to get mouse control outside of the VM window. We then click on the devices menu at the top, followed by insert guest edition CD image. After a few seconds, the install dialog opens. We click run, then enter our user password and click authenticate to start the guest editions installation. This opens a terminal on our desktop and displays the installation process. When the install completes, we press return to close the installation dialog. With the guest editions installed, mouse integration is now easier. We don't need to use the right control key to exit the VM window, and we can also drag the border of the VM, and the desktop will automatically resize to the new window size. From the VM devices menu, we have the options to enable and use shared folders and shared clipboard with the VM. After enabling these features, however, we need to restart the VM to start using them. And that's installing VirtualBox and its extension pack on an Oracle Linux Cloud instance, and using it to create a new guest virtual machine. That's the end of the video. Thanks for watching.